with Sierra RV. We are here today to talk about winterization. Truly, we should say we're here to prepare our RV for winter and winter storage, cold weather. So truly, we'll start by talking about preparing our water system for winter. With that in mind, I've got a couple of demo water heaters here. Truly, we would start by draining our water heater with our drain plugs. As you see, we have two different water heaters. Suburban has an anode rod, where Atwood has a plastic drain plug. And they use those for specific reasons. As you can see, this anode rod is looking kind of ugly. It is time to replace it. At this point, the anode rod is still good. But at this point, it's time to replace. If it looks like this, it's gone too long. So after draining our water heater, and we're getting ready to pump our antifreeze, we do want to go in and bypass the water heater. And with that in mind, we have an inlet line, an outlet line, and an adjoining bypass line. We will close the inlet, close the outlet, and open the bypass between the cold line and hot line. Same thing here. This is the most common bypass system. However, there are others that may have two valves or one valve. So truly, we don't want to pump the antifreeze into our water heater, and that's the reason why we bypass. From there, we would go into the trailer and find our water pump and connect and disconnect the inlet line from the water tank and connect the hose to the inlet. And then place into our jug of antifreeze and begin turn on the pump and begin to pump the antifreeze through all the water fixtures, faucets, showers, toilets, outside showers, spray ports, and any water fixture in the trailer. Ready to begin to winterize our freshwater plumbing system. If we haven't already, we should definitely make sure we've drained our freshwater tank. And there's always valves underneath the trailer. Well, occasionally some trailers or RVs will have an interior water tank drain. Again, if we haven't already, we should make sure that we've drained our wastewater holding tanks. Again, located under the trailer, and see that our holding tanks are drained. So now we need to, if we haven't already, drained our water heater. We'll remove the drain plug and see that the water heater is drained. So now that we have drained the water heater, we need to locate the bypass valves, which are on the backside of the water heater located inside the trailer. With, in most cases, there, if not all, there is always an access. The access may not be that easy to get to, but it's there. In this case, I know where the water heater is at the back of the trailer, and the water heater is located under this bunk. Again, we will close the inlet and close the outlet, opening the adjoining bypass. I know that this water pump is located under here. Again, with another access panel that I need to remove. Our water pump, and this manufacturer has installed a winterization valve, which is quite handy. Most trailers may not have that. From there, I would need to remove this inlet line and connect my winterization hose. So now we will place our winterization hose into our bottle of antifreeze. And open the valve to this hose. So now, as we've begun to pump our antifreeze through the faucets and fixtures, we have addressed the interior fixtures. But in most cases, if not all, we have exterior fixtures as well, outside faucets, outside spray port, and those are an item that I fairly often see that get missed in the winterization process. By all means, if you're unsure of what you're of doing the winterization process yourself, surely get it into a service center and to see that it's done properly. If we don't winterize our plumbing system correctly, we can have extreme damage, faucets, water leaks. If we fail to drain our water heater, that can be a very costly item. A water heater costs $800-$900 and can do extensive damage with a water leak and break.
$120
is not.
Okay, start that one over for us.
So with that, we need to address the plumbing fixtures that are located on the outside of the trailer or RV. In most cases, we're going to have an outside faucet or a cold water spray port. I'll just put my spray hose in there. And address this just as I would the interior faucet. Again, running it up through until it's good and pink. Item. Most RVs, if not all, will have a set of low point drains, possibly two. I recommend that we open them just like the faucet fixture to make sure we get antifreeze through those. Now, low point drains are there for several reasons. It will, in the spring, it will help us to flush the water system out and clear all the antifreeze out of the system as well. Truly, we cannot rely on these to winterize because of how these manufacturers run piping through a trailer. We end up with low points that, in the water lines that will not drain completely. Most RVs today are coming with a black tank sewer flush. In that case, we really should blow out that Santa flush. OEM manufacturer installed sewer flush systems have go in and through a vacuum breaker check valve, and water will collect in that check valve, and they will crack and blow a little bit of air through this. Enough to clear that line through that vacuum breaker and down to the tank. Just winterized what I would call more of a simple trailer. Again, a lot of RVs are coming with a little more complicated water systems and or maybe simpler water systems in a way. If we look here, again, we've got a water heater that we're going to, again, see that we remove the drain plug. Again, this is an anode rod on a Suburban water heater. So we would drain our water heater and then we would prepare to pump our antifreeze. Now this unit has a winterization fixture. It's called an Anderson valve. Not that that matters, but we have a city position. We have a water tank fill position. Dry camping means that we are pulling water from the fresh water tank using the water pump to provide water to the trailer. And we have a winterization position, which allows us to use the water pump to pump from the city water inlet here. Again, we will take our hose and an adapter and connect to the city water inlet and our hose. This also has a remote bypass valve for the water heater. So we're in normal position here. Now we're going to turn it to bypass, which will bypass the water heater joining the hot and cold line together. On this unit, we also have a water filter and we need to remove that canister. And remove the filter if it were in place for two reasons. Mainly, it's going to contaminate the filter, but if the filter is left in place, it removes all the pink out of the antifreeze and we become unsure of how strong the antifreeze is being brought through the system. With no pink, it looks like water. We also have our black tank sewer flush. Again, we need to address that with our air and see that that is blown out so that we don't damage the vacuum breaker on for the sewer flush. We need to address our battery. Our battery is susceptible to freezing and discharging throughout the winter. If our unit is parked in a location where we can keep it plugged in and keep the battery charged, that's great. If we're not in that position to keep that battery charged, and then we recommend that we remove the battery and take it into the garage or in a non-freezing environment. Again, a battery, as it discharges, will freeze and destroy the battery.